by Mercurial Mercenaries to side four, record two, side two of Jeff Wayne's musical version of The War of the Worlds. It's early in the morning, it feels like early in the morning, 11:29. You'll be pleased to know that that means that my singing voice is not yet flourished. Like I tell you, if you're a singer of a band, always try and record your vocals in the evening. It's the reason why most of the famous bands in history recorded the vocals in the middle of the night, because your vocals get the chance to do that. Anyway, this isn't a place for singing. This is a place for listening and learning. We're going to start side four with Brave New World and Dead London. We just met the artilleryman, David Essex, again on the end of record two, side one, side three. And this is now leading into my favourite song on this album. And we all need to go a little bit Mary Poppins here, a little bit Dick Van Dyke for this song. Like I said, we need to go a little bit Mary Poppins here, a little bit Dick Van Dyke, a little bit apples and pears. All right, Mary, apples and pears. Because we're talking about a Londoner now, David Essex. It's a brave new world. Look at that hair on the lens. With a hair on the lens. We could keep this as a visual effect. That's worse. Hang on. It's a brave new world. We're just a handful of men. We'll start all over again. See what I mean? It's too early in the morning. This is the song with David Essex's impossibly high scream at the end of every line of that chorus. It's a... Get like this. Gotta get like this. A bit like this. Hunch your shoulder. Like, put your head down. Hunch your shoulder. Pretend you're wearing like a flat cap. If I had a flat cap. If I had a deerstalker or something. I used to have a deerstalker that's like lying around. I've got a Sherlock Holmes outfit. Come on, we can do this. Put a hat on as well. Hang on. It's not a deerstalker to go with it there. It's a brave new world with just a handful of men. We'll start all over again. All over again. Once more, try it with me. It's a brave new world with just a handful of men. We'll start all over again. Ready? It's a brave new world with just a handful of men. We'll start all over again. Don't sing sitting down. Stand up, put your chest out, and sing to the world. It's a brave new world. We're just gonna do a lot of that as well. It's a brave new, and a pipe. It's a brave new world. We're just a handful of men. We'll start all over again. Sorry. I'll cut all this out. Side four. So yeah, Parson Nathaniel is dead. Beth's dead. The journalist, the narrator, is now on the wander again through the land, which is just covered in red weed, terraformed earth. And he comes across the artilleryman who he met earlier in the story. And we find out on this final side of vinyl that the artilleryman has a way forward, a way that he believes we will ultimately have victory over the Martians.
And we're dead, right? So we gotta make a new life where they'll never find us. You know where? underground. You should see it down there. Hundreds of miles of drains. Sweet and clean now after the rain. Dark, quiet, safe. We can build houses and everything. Start again from scratch.
Optimism.
And what's so bad about living underground, eh? It's not been so great living up here, if you want my opinion.
Here we go.
Take a look around you
at the world we've come to know.
Does it seem to be much more than a crazy circus show?
Apples and pears.
But maybe from the madness.
Madness!
Something beautiful will grow.
Oh, yes.
In a brave new world. With just a handful of men! We'll start all over again! All over again! All over again! All over again!
Shops and hospitals and barracks right under their noses, right under their feet. Everything we need, banks, prisons and schools. We'll send scouting parties to collect books and stuff, and men like you will teach the kids, not poems and rubbish, science, so we can get everything working. We'll build villages and towns and we'll play each other at cricket. Listen. Maybe one day we'll capture a fighting machine, eh? Learn how to make them ourselves and then... Wallop!
Wallop!
Our turn to do some wiping out. Whoosh with our heat ray. Whoosh! And them running and dying. Beaten at their own game. Man on top again!
Euphoric music! A whole new world underground, but we'll learn, we'll thrive, we'll survive, we'll come out, we'll get them.
Domination of the earth is fading fast, and out of the confusion the chance has come at last to build a better future from the ashes of the past in a brave new world. Give me a handful of men, we'll start all over again. Soon becomes a slave in cages of convention from the cradle to the grave. The weak fall by the wayside, but the strong will be saved in a brave new world.
With just a handful of men,
we'll start all over again.
Very few.
I'm not trying to tell you what to be. Oh no, not me. But if mankind is to survive, the people left alive, they're gonna have to build this world anew. And it's going to have to start with me and you.
Yeah!
Me and you
to tell you what to be. Oh no, oh no,
oh no, not me.
But if mankind is to survive, the people left alive, they're gonna have to build this world anew. Yes, and we will have to be the chosen few.
Chosen!
Think of all the poverty, the hatred and the lies, and imagine the destruction of all that you despise. Slowly from the ashes, that phoenix will arise
in a brave new world. With just a handful of men, we'll start all over again. Just total euphoria. It's like sugar that's been injected into your veins. It's a brave new world with just a handful of men. We'll start all over again. All over again. All over again. All over again. I've got the plan. I have the power.
Can't you just see it? Civilization starting all over again. A second chance. We'll even build a railway and tunnel to the coast. Go there for our holidays. Nothing can stop men like us. I've made a start already. Come on down here, have a look.
In the cellar was a tunnel scarcely 10 yards long that had taken him a week to dig. I could have dug that much in a day. And I suddenly had my first inkling of the gulf between his dreams and his powers.
Doing the working and the thinking that wears a fellow out. I'm ready for a bit of a rest. How about a drink, eh? Nothing but champagne. Now I'm the boss.
We drank, and then he insisted upon playing cards. With our species on the edge of extermination, with no prospect but a horrible death, we actually played games. Later he talked more of his plan, but I saw flames flashing in the deep blue night, red weed glowing, tripod figures moving distantly, and I put down my champagne glass. I felt a traitor to my kind, and I knew I must leave this strange dreamer.
Take a look around you at the world we've come to know. Does it seem to be much more than a crazy circus show?
show. Maybe from the madness something beautiful will grow.
Beauty can come from destruction. Like I was saying on the last video, beauty is always around us. It is. Nothing but red weed and death. Recurring motifs.
There were a dozen dead bodies in the Euston Road, their outlines softened by the black dust. All was still, houses locked and empty, shops closed. But looters had helped themselves to wine and food, and outside a jeweler's, some gold chains and a watch were scattered on the pavement. Stopped, staring towards the sound. It seemed as if that mighty desert of houses had found a voice for its fear and solitude. Desolating cry worked upon my mind. The wailing took possession of me. I was intensely weary, footsore, hungry and thirsty. Why was I wandering alone in this city of the dead? Why was I alive when London was lying in state in its black shroud? I felt intolerably lonely, drifting from street to empty street, drawn inexorably towards that cry. Hill, the fighting machine from which the howling came. I crossed Regent's Canal, There stood a second machine, upright, but as still as the first.
Abruptly, the sound ceased.
Suddenly, the desolation, the solitude, became unendurable. While that voice sounded, London had still seemed alive. Now, suddenly, there was a change, the passing of something, and all that remained was this gaunt, quiet. I looked up and saw a third machine. It was erect and motionless, like the others. An insane resolve possessed me. I would give my life to the Martians here and now. I marched recklessly towards the Titan and saw that a multitude of black birds were circling and clustering about the hood. I began running along the road. I felt no fear, only a wild, trembling exultation as I ran up the hill towards the motionless monster. Out of the hood hung red shreds at which the hungry birds now pecked and tore. Hill, and the Martians' camp was below me. A mighty space it was, and scattered about it in their overturned machines were the Martians, dead, slain after all man's devices had failed by the humblest things upon the earth. Bacteria. Minute, invisible bacteria.
Bacteria! Killed by the common cold. Or something along those lines.
Directly the invaders arrived and drank and fed, our microscopic allies attacked them. From that moment, they were doomed.
Oh, that's a two-finger bass. This time. It's a brave world. We're just a handful of men.
Was ended. The people scattered over the country, desperate, leaderless, starved. The thousands who had fled by sea, including the one most dear to me, all would return. The pulse of life, growing stronger and stronger, would beat again.
Mm. bass solo.
As life returns to normal, the question of another attack from Mars causes universal concern. Is our planet safe? Or is this time of peace merely a reprieve? It may be that across the immensity of space, they have learned their lessons and even now await their opportunity. Perhaps the future belongs not to us, but to the Martians.
Getting great pictures here at NASA Control Pasadena. The landing craft touched down on Mars 28 kilometers from the aim point. We're looking at a remarkable landscape. It's littered with different kinds of rocks, red, purple. How about that, Bermuda?
Fantastic. Look at that dune field.
Hey, wait, I'm getting a no-go signal. Now I'm losing one of the craft. Hey, Bermuda, you getting it?
I lost contact. A lot of dust blowing up there.
Now I lost the second craft. We got problems.
All contact lost, Pasadena.
Oh, shit.
Maybe the antennas.
What's that flare? You see it? A green flare coming from Mars. Kind of a green mist behind it. It's getting closer. You see it, Bermuda?
And round and round.
Come in, Bermuda.
And round.
Houston, come in.
Houston.
What's going on?
We have a problem.
Tracking station 43, Canberra. Come in, Canberra. Tracking station 63. Can you hear me, Madrid? Can anybody hear me? Come in. Come in.
Thank you, my mercenaries. That was Jeff Wayne's musical version of War of the Worlds. Overall, I think that's quite an experience as far as albums go. If there's a downside to it, I could probably do about that epilogue. The bit at the end with NASA. Pasadena Control, where they land on Mars, just sort of in our era, like Elon Musk wants to do right now. So we go to Mars. And when we get there, what's that flare? See it? A green flare coming from Mars. Kind of green mist behind it. It's getting closer. You see it? Bermuda, come in. Bermuda, Houston, come in. What's going on? What gets me is, if in like 1897 or whatever, the Earth was basically destroyed by Martian beings and a red weed took over the planet and wiped out like half the population. And there were Martians scattered dead across the landscape because of bacteria, whatever. And fighting machines all just laying strewn across the landscape. And then 100 years later or so, we go to Mars and we're surprised that there's something out there and it catches us by surprise. It's like the person who wrote the epilogue didn't think that perhaps mankind would always remember what happened in 1897. We'd have relics in the museums. We'd have, not only would we have kind of Martians preserved for us to look at. We'd also have some of the fighting machines in the museums, and the scientists would have been working on the technology from the fighting machines, and our whole culture and civilization would be built on the mythos of the red weed and the Martians and the fact we're not alone in the universe. And then later on, we go to Mars and we're surprised that there are Martians there. So overall, the album ends on a bit of a silly note. And if I could, I'd wipe out that last track, but never mind, because it's kind of that, it was a 1978 twist ending. That's what it is, a 1978 twist ending. So on that note, we'll cut it some slack, okay? But for those of you that went on this journey with me, much appreciated. Doing it in little bite sizes like this is a little bit more manageable, but I do appreciate it. I mean, all in all, as a playlist, watching all the videos in order, you've certainly got a lot of War of the Worlds content there. But if you got this far, and it's only a handful of us, in a brave new world, with just a handful of mercurial mercenaries, we'll start all over again! All over again! So thank you very much. And I don't know whether I'll include this little bit on the end or not that I'm about to say now, but I had a major catastrophic failure during my favourite song, Brave New World, where the audio completely cut out. In fact, the video, everything just collapsed. So I had to make a decision there and then whether to re-record it all properly or go with the audio off the camera rather than the audio off the actual audio equipment. And I think I've made the decision right now to go with the audio off the camera. And so I've got probably, to edit this video together now, I've probably got, it's probably the hardest video I've ever done, unfortunately. This will probably take me longer to do this than it took for the bacteria to kill the Martians. But we'll see how it goes. So if you noticed the audio is a bit odd during Brave New World, that's the reason for it. Well, if you notice anything was odd during Brave New World, it's because, quite aptly, I think, perhaps, given David Essex's attempts at describing how he would create a whole new world for mankind underground, where all he could do was just dig a few centimetres into the mud with his bare fingers. Given that that was happening while all my technological equipment was breaking down, it's probably quite apt. Probably quite apt. But thank you very much. Thank you very much. It was definitely a journey. One of my favourite albums, just because it's an album you can put on and really listen to and, you know, it's almost like watching a film, but the film plays out in your head. I suppose all music's like that, really, to a certain extent. But thank you. Over and...